they on it. Boss talk. It's a unique hustle.
Check it, check it, check it. It's a unique hustle. It's your boy ECEO, and I'm here with the lovely, amazing, official Miss Jamaica. What's going on?
Nothing,
my dad. Man, hey, man. We are here today celebrating, man. It's going down, man. Hey, man, something I've been trying to do ever since I started this whole podcast world, man. It was something that was dear to me. I wanted to give people their roses while they were here, man. And this guy right here, I didn't get to meet. And so I had wanted to bless whoever I could find that connected with him when he was here. So who better to do that than Ronnie and my boy Wendell Struggs? What's going on, baby?
What's going on, man?
These guys are here, man. Say, man, and we here in love and memory of C Struggs, man.
That's what's up.
So, man, hey, man, you know, the show, man, like I said, the music in the city, the love in the city was on a different level when C Struggs was here, really. It was some stuff happened after that. They kind of really spent this thing in, out of control. You know what I mean? Yeah. After his passing, you know, in Dallas, you know. But I just want to celebrate his birthday today, man. You know, dope, man. I mean, his lyrics, the way that he brought it. Bruh, I mean, he put his heart into the music, man. So I want to ask y'all a few questions about it, man. I start with you, Ronnie. Like, when did y'all know that he loved music?
As a little boy? Man, bro, just throw poetry as a little boy. He just...
How old when you say little boy?
I'm talking little, like probably 9 years old, 8 years old.
Nine or eight?
Nine.
Yeah.
He loved poetry.
Yeah, he just drew attention, man. He just grabbed a mic.
And go in.
And go in. Just go
from
in.
From 8 to 9 years old?
Like 8 to 9 years old. He always had that voice to draw people in. Like
it. Where did he get it from, though?
Man, this big bro listen to the OGs around the house, the UGKs, you know, AGs, you know what I'm saying, ghetto boys.
Who was his biggest inspiration?
His biggest inspiration, man, I want to say bro was one of them, yes.
Who was?
Bro, my big bro.
You used to rap?
Bro, no, not like inspiration.
Just his inspiration to keep pushing toward the music.
You know what I'm saying? And grinding, but the inspiration on the rap is like Scarface.
I seen that Brad Jordan Jr.
Scarface. Yeah, UGK, 8-Ball, MJG. Oh, man,
he loved
listening to all those guys, man.
But then, you know, when you look at it, Wendell, man, you ain't had many to come with that sound, man. I had a guy in here the other day, Ty Harris. And Ty Harris plays the piano.
That's my boy.
And Ty was like, man, because I told him it was this one cat that kind of, you know, he doing his thing in the city. I say, you're a big guy like C Struggs. He said, you say C Struggs, that's some big shoes to feel, nigga. He pretty much put it out there right exactly as soon as I said that. Who was that big boy?
Big X the Plug.
Big X the Plug. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that nigga going hard, ain't he?
Yeah, he hard right now.
You like him?
Yeah, I like him.
Yeah, he supposed to been on the show, but he canceled.
Something happened, yeah.
And then he went to jail that night.
Yep.
I sure hope he at home, because I need him to be on the show 2022 early.
Oh, really?
You know what I'm saying? So that's your guy.
Yeah, he doing his thing, though.
Man, I love when these niggas be rapping. So y'all never got into the music. Y'all just supported C Struggs.
Nah, I just supported him, bro.
Yeah, that's it.
How many brothers?
Yeah, there's three.
Y'all three.
Any sisters?
Just one. She passed away.
Oh, okay.
She passed away as well? Yes. What did she pass away from?
She was like a diabetic, you know.
She was diabetic.
Yeah, different health issues along the years, so, you know.
Like pneumonia and...
How old was she when she passed?
29.
Yeah,
man. So how does that? And I know, cause take it from my uncle, all my uncles are passed away except for one from my daddy's side. My daddy had eight brothers and five sisters, and there's only two left, and the youngest and the oldest.
And the oldest, everybody in between is gone.
And I always wonder, like, dang, man, I went to so many different funerals over the years, bro. But when I would go, you know, it's like, dang, man, it's my family. And it made me think about my health. I'm being real with y'all. I mean, most people don't want to be real. You know what I'm saying? It made me think about me. And I'm like, dang, God, you still got me here. And I see niggas that's my age that pass away, and they be like, dang, I don't know why, but God, he has a way of showing you that there's a purpose and a place for your life, right?
Yeah, right.
So I just be thinking about that kind of stuff. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. That you still here, and these guys didn't make it to be even your age. And you like, my mom didn't even make it to be my age. So mm-hmm. It's kind of like she passed away with cancer. So it's like, it makes you think, bro. It makes you think. It makes you try to do it, what, eat different, try to figure out some ways to make your life somewhat different. But in reality, it is what it is. Everybody got to get out of here one day.
Mm-hmm.
Period. We all born dying. And that's what people don't really like to look at, that reality. But I always tell people, death don't have to be a bad thing. It's bad to us because we don't understand the other side. But if you believe like I believe, then you read and you understand what you're headed for. So you have a little glimpse of what's on the other side. But at the end of the day, you have to have a strong faith and belief system in order to even tap into that world. Does that make sense?
Most definitely.
So I enjoy life every day. Like Roy Lee say, smile, enjoy life every day.
Enjoy life, smile every day.
So how did he end up in Dallas, and just the way that Dallas embraced him?
And that's where we grew. That's where we grew up. You know, we from Ennis, Texas.
Okay.
We grew up in Dallas, Oak Cliff.
Mm-hmm.
Oak Cliff.
Yeah, Glen Oaks.
Wow. And so that's where that tenacity, that pull, that drive come from.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So when you first started seeing him in the music, what made you realize, hey, this boy got something?
All right. Like when I'm go back for a minute. Like when he first went to college, you know, he came home, I picked him up from college, you know, I was at the trap or whatever, you know, and he was like, big bro, I want you to listen to something. So I was like, wait a minute, you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna put you in right quick. And so I didn't put him in right then, but later on down the line, I dropped the CD in there and he went to doing something. Beast of the Click, a lot of more songs. And so, you know, I was in prison, you know, in and out of prison, that lifestyle I live. So I received the album cover from one of my partners. And he was like, look, your bro on the radio and everything. Him and Rick Ross right now, you know what I'm saying? Listen to it on the radio on the streets where Sunday. So I was like, all right, that's a bit. So Sunday came. And there it was. And man, I just broke down, you know, in the middle of it all, you know, and I had made parole at the same time and felt like he made it right then, you know.
Wow. So when you was locked up, you knew he was messing with the music.
Right.
But you didn't know it had stuck.
Right. No, I didn't know. He had like, you know, album after album, you know, mixtape after mixtape, but never, you know, them big hitters, you know what I'm saying? And when I seen him with Rick Ross, man, it was just like a whole nother level.
How did that happen? I heard about it when it was going on. I'm like, how in the hell did Rick? I know he was a big guy, so Rick was a big guy, and I'm like, maybe that's how what made them connect. You know?
No, it was a model, an Instagram model from Instagram.
Okay.
And she put up a post trying to be funny, like name this rapper. You know, had my big brother toting the chopper, and so. You know, big guy, they were like, name this rapper, they're trying to be funny.
Yeah, yeah.
Everybody laughing and giggling. So I was like, all right.
Yeah.
All right, and Rick Ross seen it.
Yeah.
You know, in the comments, he seen it. He said, oh, yeah. They really go hate this Rick Ross. It's C Struggs record, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, I see you grinding, big boy.
He said, I'm finna come do something with you.
Yeah.
That's God.
God.
That's
God.
Favor.
Yes.
See, favor ain't fair.
Yeah.
Right.
See, favor make. See, it was a lot of niggas that wanted to get a feature mm-hmm. from Rick Ross.
Oh yeah.
And I'm be honest with you, for the way God'll do it, man, he don't go by standards and set rules, man. You feel me?
Right.
Like it'll push you up the line. It don't matter. DJ Khaled might have wanted a verse that week. It didn't matter. God said, nah, we gonna put DJ Khaled gonna get his, but we gonna put C Struggs up there. You see what I'm saying? Sure. Favor ain't fair, man. That's dope, though. That's a dope story. So how did he reach out to him?
Called him.
He just called him.
Yeah.
Wow.
He like, send me your number. I'm going to call you. 15 minutes later.
And they called.
He called.
What did C. Struggs say? How did he react to it?
It's like, Like, wow. You like,
it messed him up.
Yeah, it messed him up. He was like, man, you don't know how much it means for you to call me. I thought you were just, you know what I'm saying, playing around, you know what I'm saying? You hit me right,
right back.
You know, big bro was there with the kids. He called. That would make him so happy. He'd be there with his kids to get that call, man.
They seen that.
They seen that. You know.
But you can't make this up. Go ahead.
That's why sometimes you know. I always say our life is not our own. So many people watch our lives and change because of it. You know what I mean? Some people can look at that instance of how she was making fun of him, and somebody else who didn't even comment but saw that and felt, you know, a certain way because of it, because they might be in that same situation, being bullied in a certain way, but then see how something good came out of it, and that could have motivated that person as well. So a lot of times, you know, when we live our lives and we might be affected badly by something, but people are watching you constantly and watching to see how you react, how you overcome. That's why another reason why we love this platform so much, because a lot of people are stuck on YouTube, on their phones all the time, and going through situations. We all are human beings. Everybody goes through something. And when you're going through things, you think you're the only one who's going through it. Nobody else will ever understand what you're going through, no matter what you're going through. But to actually have people come on the platform and say certain things about things that they've been through and how they overcame it, and then that could actually help someone who is listening. You know what I mean?
I agree 100%.
Yeah, we was going through something during that time, you know, right before that. Rest in peace, my nephew, Tory Struggs, Tito, you know, C Struggs' son. He had a drowning accident in 2014.
I seen that.
And so, you know, we was trying to put everything together, you know, and make it past this moment and get somewhere else, and then, you know, God just rewarded, you know.
Wow. And it's crazy how it happened. So how he was, how 14? How was his son?
Six.
He was uh-huh. six.
This happened in 2014.
And he basically how did that affect C Struggs, which is something we know it was terrible, horrific.
It knocked the fight out of him for a few weeks, months, but after that he came harder than ever. He was like, hey, this it. Ain't no looking back, you know.
Man.
And it gave him the motivation he needed to get where he needed to be at, you know.
Would you say that was the most difficult thing he had to face in his life?
Yes.
Going through his own medical condition at that time, and then going through that too. Oh, man. It made him a monster in the studio. Yeah.
People don't understand how depression can take a toll on your body as well. You know what? Not only mentally, but physically. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I know. So he ended up having cancer, right?
Yes.
And I seen him on his last interview, but I seen that video with Smalls, the one you took him down there to do. And
I was in a room with him.
And and he was on there. And one thing that stuck out to me about him was the way that he just left it all out there on anything he was doing, the music. He didn't hide nothing. They asked him about his eye. He told him how he felt about it. I ain't checking it or whatever. Was that a part of the cancer that was making that happen, you think?
It might have been.
You see what I'm saying? Because I remember he said it was some, on that last interview, it was some tumors and some stuff that was affecting.
Yeah, he was dealing with a lot of stuff, but he was like, just music going to come first before anything.
Even
you know?
When that was going on.
Yeah. Right. The music.
He's like, I had to get this out. Yeah. What was the last thing that he was trying to get out that he had to get out and he got it done?
Why not hustle too?
Yeah,
why not? I heard him speak on that.
Yes.
Why not hustle too? He was like, I got to get this one out, man.
Right. This is during the time he was going back and forth for chemo, different things, you know, and right before his surgery.
And he said, I got to get this thing out before my surgery.
Yes. Is it because he felt like he needed to leave a legacy for his kids, or why is that?
Yes, most definitely.
Yeah.
And he knew his, you know, he came to the realization that his time might have been coming, you know,
him. Did he speak about it?
He wrote a song about it. I can feel it.
I can feel it.
Yes.
And he knew.
Yes, he knew.
Wow, man. That's a deep story.
And I've never been put in a situation, but I've heard people say it a lot. So when people are going through things where they know what is about to come, does that help prepare you as a loved one to expect that as well? Like, to prepare you for that?
For me, it did. Like, I just know if he was comfortable and it set in for him, I was comfortable and I'd be there strong for his boys.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know, but it was a tough thing to prepare for.
Yeah.
But I knew it was coming, so I had to be strong for his boys.
For his boys.
Yeah.
That's what kept you going.
That was his everything.
His boys.
Yeah.
I could only imagine.
Mm-hmm.
I know you keep in touch with them, and you guys spend time with them, and they come down and all that good stuff.
They come down.
He have them all the time.
Man, I love it, man.
You have boys for yourself?
My guys. Oh, no.
No kids?
So C-Struggs, he's smiling down.
Right.
Yeah, so they're your kids, too.
They're my kids,
You don't
too,
need right. none. Now you got here.
I got a lot of nieces and nephews.
That's real, man. Right. Yeah, man. I mean, you know, y'all got to bring them by here. When you do get them, we got to bless them, bro.
Yeah.
We already was in there. I told you about our situation. We ain't going to go into it. But whenever you get them and y'all riding around, man, just call me, please.
Yeah.
Right.
And we're going to rock out. Okay. That's how I do it, man. I'm burning. Go back and look at some of my episodes. I just rock out, man.
Because
I know already if I do it now, I know I'm doing what I'm supposed to do. You see what I'm saying?
Right.
So just please, you know what I'm saying? Call me, bro.
Right.
Call and don't be bashful. Just say, hey, E, I got them boys with me. And watch what happens.
All right.
That's the realness of it.
Yeah,
and like I said, we can cut the cameras off. I ain't tripping. I just want to, you know, I want to see them. Okay.
I appreciate that.
Man, y'all dope, bro. Who are y'all listening to in the music now? And who was he really, really tight with? Because he had songs with everybody from Puka Leroy to that boy had songs with a lot of people. Rick Ross.
Yeah.
E-40.
E-40.
Dazzin' Grip.
Come on, man. How did he get the song with E-40?
Reached out. Bro was authentic. You know his music. Yeah, a lot of people listen to bro.
Yeah, I remember taking him to a meet and greet at a liquor store in Glen Heights over there, and him and E-40 was chopping it up, and E-40 was like, "Hey, we need to go and do this," you know. And so, one thing led to another, you know. And it's the type of music he wrote, life story for life story. It's real. You can feel it, you know.
But the thing is, he did things that people that's in the Dallas-Fort Worth area that got hot as they could get, never done.
Yeah,
bro. Right. Think about that for a second.
Right.
Bro, so talented. He did a song with a group from Mexico.
What?
They didn't speak no English.
Yeah. He rapped in Spanish. I remember that.
He rapped in Spanish?
Yeah. It was like, they had a translator.
Okay.
And all he knew what they wanted the song to be about, they were like, party.
That's it. And he went in.
Man,
that's dope, bro. Like those are stories that you can hold on to.
Right.
Yeah.
Right?
Do you see any of his kids wanting to rap?
No.
The boys probably just want to be kids, man.
Kids right now.
Yeah, they ain't trying to rap. They in the kids, though. The games.
That's old.
They play sports. One play basketball. One play football.
Yeah. They were doing that when I talked to them.
Are they good?
Yeah, they good.
That's good.
So do you... go ahead.
Now, don't get me wrong. Like when one of his songs come on or something, they'll go word for word with it.
They gonna rock with it.
Just like he did when he was young, you know.
Yeah. They gonna rock out with
him.
Right.
Yeah.
Man, that's dope, man. So what has been the hardest time? Like, have the kids ever came to you and be like, "Hey, man, about their dad since these years have passed by?"
Yeah.
They'll come and talk to you about it.
Yeah.
Y'all get past. Y'all was like, "Hey, man, you know."
Yeah. Then we'll talk about it.
Because how many years apart was y'all?
We just 9 months apart.
See what I'm saying? So you knew every single thing, everything that was going on with him, you could speak on it. So that's a blessing, man, for them kids to have that. Now go ahead. You were about to say something.
Just we built that bond, the kids. So they tell me everything. They're in school, they'll call, tell me what they're going through, what's happening. I tell them the right thing to do. That's the way I know how, what I'm saying? I'll be there for their mama. She called me out the blue every other day.
I bet y'all used to be fighting you and your brother, man.
Man.
9 months apart.
Hey, these were my first kids. I tell everybody that.
9 months apart, nigga?
9 months apart, man.
I had a lot of brother wars, man.
And y'all fought other folks.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, they didn't fight each other and fight other folks. Did he get mad? Yeah.
How much older are you than they are?
Oh, that's big brother.
Oh, yeah. I was 10 when they was born. So.
Oh, okay. 10 years. 10 years.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, man. Okay. Man, that's dope, man. Yeah. I tell you, man.
Did the kids have to go through counseling or anything like that?
I really would just talk to them.
Just talk to them.
They got him.
Yeah.
They got unks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think that matters.
They call me from time to time, but I'm like the just like always on the go, you know.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I started from scratch when I got out, so I'm, you know, I was trying to get my years back at the same time.
Yeah, yeah.
When bro passed away, I ain't gonna lie, I kind of lost my mind, you know, really? For a minute. Yeah.
How long was you going?
With him a lot.
Yes, I was. I was taking him everywhere, you
right.
know.
Yeah.
To the different shows and stuff, you know. I was actually, you know, right there with him. Me and a couple of Clone 3 members also, you know. Shout out to Tank, you know, Spiffy, you know, Plug.
Yeah.
You know, all of them. You know, ATM, yeah. D-Love, shout out to the boy.
Shout out Clone 3, yeah.
Yeah. Those are guys, who, these are guys that still talk to holler at y'all.
Yeah, D-Love. Clone 3, ATM.
Yeah. So these guys will still reach out and say, hey, man, how you guys doing?
Oh, yeah.
Is his mom still living?
Oh, yes, yeah. My mom's still living.
So how did she handle losing him?
She took it hard.
Yeah, she did. She took it hard. You know, after losing, you know, her nephew, her grandson, and then, you know, my brother, and then, you know, her son, and then, you know, she lost another brother, our uncle, so, you know, she's been through some things, and her aunt, so, you know,
her sister. Yeah, she lost her brother and her sister. They all right after each other.
Right after each other.
Man, but like I said, I've been through that, so I get it. And as far as just the losing the close loved ones, and just, it takes a toll on you, but like I said, man, God got you here for a reason, for them boys, mm-hmm. and you know what I mean, for your mom, and so therefore you have to stand strong, right?
Right.
You have to stand strong.
Got to.
Man, well, we here celebrating, man, C Struggs' birthday today, man. It's going down, man. My wife, we want to present you guys with a plaque mm-hmm. that we had. We had gotten it, and we this is what we do here at Boss Talk 101. We try to hand out roses while we have the opportunities to. And this here, what does it say?
It says, presented to Corey Struggs, a.k.a. C. Struggs, in recognition of not only being the hardest rapper in Dallas with hits like Do It, How You Come, and Work, a talented songwriter and musician, 2021.
Dope, man. Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Appreciate that.
Yeah, that's the dope part, man. That, you know what I mean? Hold on to that, man. That with them boys, share it with them boys, man. Like, it's still happening. It's still going down, man.
Yeah, I appreciate y'all so much.
Man, come on, man. This is where it's supposed to go, bro.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Oh, yeah. If we don't do it, who going to do it? Like, that's the thing. Like, I don't know what other people do, but we do what God tell us to do. You know what I'm saying?
Thank
y'all
so much.
Man, Boss Talk 101, man. That's what we're doing. We're giving people roses while they're here, bro. Yeah, and that's the only way we know to do it, man. Like I said, I don't know how else to do it. We just basically come into this game, and those guys are the guys that, that's who we thought of. The Dunn mm-hmm. Chiefs, the Dunn Chiefs, all of the different people that, the Lucha and Pookies, the ones who originated this thing in Dallas, man. You remember Ron C, man?
Ron C.
Y'all don't know mm-hmm. about that.
Yeah.
What was that?
You grew up listening to Ron C too? Yeah. Cottonmouth.
Just the dopest thing to have, the legacy that Dallas holds, man. The Pooka Leroy's, like I said, not only him, man, the Trap Boy Freddy's, the Yellows, man, the Mo 3's, man. Yeah. This thing here is real, bro. Did he ever get a chance to work with Mo3 or any of those younger cats?
Trap Boy.
Yeah.
No Voucher.
Yellow, my boy. I'm trying to get that boy on him, man. Yeah. It's and we working. I rock with his camp. So Lo Deezy be on here. This is I just talking to him last night. Mm-hmm. We always that's his manager. We all rock. I'm an older cat, so I'm gonna talk to the older niggas. Oh, you feel me?
Already.
So what did you get locked up for? I want to ask you that.
Man, I was a trap star, man. I ain't even gonna start.
You
I'm a trap star. It's in the songs. Man. You can hear it in the song. My big bro, Dale.
That nigga put it down, man. My big brother, nigga.
It was like we was all in it together. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. We didn't have no mama. Our daddy was gone. You know, mama was gone. So it was just us, me and my little brothers. You know, I had kids of my own. You know, it's in that song. I can feel it too. So, you know, we had to do what we had to do, you know.
We had to get it.
That I can feel. That's your favorite one?
Yeah. We come a long way from eating, you know, hamburger helper with no meat. You know,
man, that's the part that make you what don't kill you make you stronger.
Oh, right.
So y'all went through some things and shared some strong, strengthening times.
Right.
Man.
Yeah.
Right.
Oh yeah.
Man. So like I said, I think y'all told me. Did y'all tell me who y'all favorite peep person is out doing music right now? Yeah, I'm gonna get it out of here. Yeah, cause y'all niggas done listen. Y'all got an ear.
Yeah, I listen. Yeah. A lot of these cats I listen to, like Big X, one of them.
That yeah, we talked about that boy Big go X, hard. Yeah, so you think do he do? Because I made that statement about him being like a C Struggs. Do you be like look at him like he bringing
yeah,
it?
Yeah.
He a big nigga.
He a big nigga doing his thing.
You know and that's what I looked
I see
at.
I see that hungry him too. Yeah.
There you go. So you can see it in him.
Yeah.
I got that boy.
I seen him well before his name caught the air.
You say okay?
You know I'm going across Facebook. You know what I'm saying? A long time ago.
Yeah.
I heard a song. I hit him up like yeah. You got it, yeah.
That's good.
Wow,
like you got it, yeah.
That's dope, man. So, what about you, big bro?
Man, I
Wendell.
You know what I'm saying? I fade them all. You know, all of them sound good to me. But one thing, you know, about Mo 3, he went through that. It seemed like he went through that struggle, kind of like we did before we made it big. So, you know,
that pain in the music, right,
you know,
man.
Staying in the car for a while, you know, a couple of days or whatever, you know. Feel like sometimes your family turned back on you, you know, and just, you know, had to do what you had to do. So this kind of like, you know, inspired me and my brothers coming up. So, you know, like my brother East is like, hey man, listen to this or such. And he said, what you think about Mo 3, you know, Yellow, you know, a Trap Boy? I'm like, hey, I'm fool with them all.
Yeah,
you
ask
know
you
saying?
About it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I listen to it all. Yeah.
Everybody.
Yeah. I support this Dallas stuff.
That Dallas stuff real, ain't it, man?
For sure.
Yeah.
Man, so, man, I want to tell y'all, we love you, man. Ronnie, Wendell, man, we love you guys, man. If, like I said, don't forget what we talked about on that other deal. Just come see me, man. Don't let this be your, you know, last time. Y'all know I'm here. I've been here 15 years.
Yeah, really.
So it ain't like God had us here 15 years. So, you know, I just say we here. And we love you. We love C Struggs. Happy birthday, C Struggs. I know you looking down on
us. Happy birthday,
smiling down on us, man.
Sir.
Smiling, man.
Smiling down on us.
Sir, I can hear him now. Let go.
Say, man, it's been another great segment of Boss Talk 101 where the bosses talk.
And we are. Okay, Boss Talk Podcast would like to present you with this award for Corey Struggs. It says, presented to Corey Struggs, a.k.a. C Struggs, in recognition of not only being the hardest rapper in Dallas with hits like Do It, How You Come, and Work, a talented songwriter and musician 2021.
Hey, man. Thank you so much.
Happy birthday, C Struggs, man. Say, man, check it, man. We out here. We giving roses out while they here, baby.
Yeah.
Man, that's the only way we could do it, man. Man, big love, man.
Yeah,
big love.
Appreciate y'all. Boss Talk 101.
101 with a boss's talk.
Yeah.